When it comes to root mean square, or RMS, there's a number of different ways that the term is used. One way it's used is to describe an amplitude format, and another way it's used is to describe the overall level of energy in a spectrum. Let's talk about amplitude formats first. When talking about amplitude formats, we're talking about the way that the amplitude of a sine wave at each spectral line is expressed. So if we have a sine wave, there's a number of ways that we could express its amplitude. One could be by expressing its amplitude in peak format, so taking the peak amplitude of the sine wave. A different way we could express it is in RMS format, or by taking the peak and multiplying it by 0.707. This gives a better representation of the equivalent steady state energy of that sine wave. So if we want to change the amplitude format of our spectrum, we can simply right-click, go under processing. Right now our spectrum is in peak, but we could change it to RMS, and as we would expect, the levels would go down a bit. Keeping in mind that this is the exact same data, just represented with a different amplitude format. Now the next way we're going to talk about RMS is the RMS of a spectrum, and that's going to give us a representation of the overall level of energy in the spectrum. And it's just going to boil down to one number. To calculate the RMS of a spectrum, right-click on the legend, go to Options, Calculated Content, scroll down to RMS, add it to your selection, and hit Apply. And essentially, this number is going to be a representation of the overall level of energy in the spectrum. Now, if you want to calculate the RMS over a narrower frequency range, you can right-click and add a double cursor, slide your cursor over your frequency range of interest, right-click on the cursor, and go to Calculations, and then RMS. And that'll give you the RMS just within that frequency range. Check out the article below for more information on RMS and how RMS is calculated. Thanks for watching.